Alright. It says identify the cross section. Well, you count the sides on this thing. This one right here has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That little one counts as a side. So it's a pentagon. A five-sided figure is called a pentagon. What is a six-sided figure called?
Hexagon.
A hexagon. What about a seven-sided figure? It's called a septagon or heptagon. I've seen it both ways. Number two says surface area and lateral area. Scratch that out and put volume. Volume of a box is just LWH. So L is 14. W is 7. And the height of this thing is 1.66. Now, I don't want to use my calculator and waste time. I'm sure you can just multiply this out. Is everybody clear on how to do that? All right, next. Number three says volume again is what we're going to do. It works the same way. So 13.2 times 3.9 times 6. Real easy. When we get to surface area, it's a little harder. But for right now, we'll leave it as volume. Next page. Volume, they left the answers in pi. So you got to multiply. You got to multiply. I'll come back. You got to multiply this answer, 1.75 times 3.14, to compare it to your answer. Now, you might have to do it a few times, but so what? You'll figure it out eventually. But the formula is volume is big B times H. Well, big B is a circle, so that's pi radius squared times the height of this, which is 14. So you get your calculator, you multiply 3.14 times radius squared, so that's going to be 5 times 5, times the height, which is 14. Now, if you want to get the answer they have, instead of putting 3.14, scratch that out and put pi. Now, 5 times 5 is 25. So 25 times 14, that gives me 350 pi. So I'm looking for this one right here as my answer. Is everybody clear on what I did? I don't care how you do it. If
so
you wanna,
why didn't you multiply it with the pi?
Because my answer choices were in terms of pi. You got to understand both ways, even if I didn't show it to you. The next one works the same way. So it's pi radius squared times the height. The height is 12. The radius is 4. So that's 4 times 4. So that's 16 times 12. The answer should be 192 pi on this one. And there it is right there. Any questions on what I'm saying? If they give you the answer in terms of pi, I don't care how you do it, figure it out. It's pretty easy. Number four, I missed it, so let's work that one. It says the volume of a cylinder. So write down your equation. Volume equals big B times H. Once you write down your equation, substitute. If they tell you the volume, then in place of the V, you're going to put 980 pi. So 980 times pi is equal to base, which is pi radius squared times the height. Copy this down and try to understand what I'm doing. They want you to find the height. No, it says what is the radius? They want the radius. So stay with me. Any questions so far on what I did? Now, if you divide both sides by pi, watch what happens.
They give you the height, though.
Okay. Let me come back to it. If we divide everything, thank you. If you divide everything by pi, the pi's cancel. So knock out the pi's. So now your equation reduces to 980 is equal to radius squared times the height. And like he said, the height is right here. So put 20 right there. Any questions so far? Now, take your calculator. We're going to divide by 20 So what's 980 divided by 20?
49.
So put 49. So 49 is equal to radius squared. Now, what's the opposite of a square? No, not really. It's that weird looking symbol. Anybody know? It's called the square root. So on this one, you got to do the square root of both sides. So cancel out that and say R is equal to 7, because 7 times 7 is equal to 49. So the radius, or the answer that I gave you on the back page, better be 7. Any questions on what I did? You got to work it backwards. It's on video. You can watch it a million times. Rework it. Shut the video off. Rework it. All right, let's go on. This one right here says, this one is very similar. So put a star by this one. It says the volume. So put volume equals big B times H. Put volume equals pi radius squared times H. Sit down, please. All right, hurry up. The volume is 271.4. So put 271.4. Pi is 3.14. The radius is 6, so put 6 times 6. And we must be looking for the height. Any questions about what I did so far? Again, write down your equation. You have a question? Substitute your numbers in there. Now, let's work it. Put your calculator on your desk. Start it up. Press 271.4. So 271.4. Now, we want to divide by 3.14. So divide it. 3.14, press equals, divide by 6, and then divide by 6 again. And whatever's left should be the height. The height is about 2.4. Verify that on the back page. Here it is right here. So it's got to be A on that one.
It is.
Is everybody clear on what I did? Don't panic on this. Just write down your equation, plug your numbers in. Again, you can watch the video until you're sure you can do it, because I'm showing you what your test is. All right, next. This one right here is a composite. It's a box plus half a cylinder. Half of a cylinder. So let's find the box first. So that's easy. So that's 9 times 11 times 6 equals some answer. And we'll put that in a minute. Now let's do the cylinder. The cylinder is pi radius squared times the height
divided by 2,
because we only want half of it. Well, we know what pi is, so put 3.14. The radius on this thing, well, if this is 9, then this piece is 9, and that actually is the diameter. So 9, and then half of that is 4.5. So the radius is 4.5. Make sure you understand how I got that radius. And then the height of this box is actually going to be the same as that. So from here to here, from circle to circle, is 11. So the height of that is 11. Now what you got to do is get your calculator, and we're going to do it right now. So let's do this one. 6 times 9 is 54. So let's take 54 times 6. Let me make sure I got that right. Yeah, times 11 is what it should be. So times 11. Verify with me, make sure you get 594. Anybody else got that? All right, thanks. Now clear your calculator out. Press 3.14 times 4.5 times 4.5 times 11. Press equals. Now take this number, 699 and some change, and add whatever we have there. So plus 594. Did I divide by 2?
No.
All right, back up. Let me back up. All right, all of that came to 699, and I didn't divide by 2. All right, so put, thank you, 699. I'm going to be off a little bit. Divide it by 2.
It says you have to round to the whole number anyway.
Okay, so let's make that 349.5 for right now. Now add that 594 plus 594, and let's try to get one close to it. So 943. 943 is close to what? I'm going to go with that one. Now, number 9 should work the same way, so I don't want to do that again. Just make sure you divide by 2, okay? All right, next. Number 10. Number 10 is a pyramid. So that's going to be volume equals big B times H. The base is a square, so that's going to be 11 times 11 times the height of this thing, which is 15. But it comes to a point, so I have to divide by what?
3.
I have to divide by 3. Now, 3 goes into 3 once. How many times does 3 go into 15?
5.
5. So take 121, which is 11 times 11, 121 times 5, and that should be my answer. I get 605, and it's right there. Any questions on what I did? If you don't know how to reduce, don't worry about it. Just use your calculator. All right, next page. This one is the same way. Just remember to divide by 3. All right, let's do the cone. The cone is going to be volume is big B times H. Well, the base is a circle, so that's pi radius squared times the height. And since it comes to a point, you have to divide by 3. Now, I'm going to work this one, even though there's 2. I'm only going to do one of them. So pi is 3.14. The radius on this thing is 8, so you got to write it twice because it's radius squared. And the height of this cone is 17, and then you got to divide by 3. So let's do this one. Well, 8 times 8 is 64. So take 64 times 17 and then times 3.14. Press equals. Make sure you press equals. Divide by 3. I get 1138. So it's got to be this one, 1139. Any questions on what I said or what I did? All right, it's going to be on video. You can watch it all weekend. This one right here is a sphere. I'm sorry, So it's going to be 4/3 pi radius cubed. Try to memorize that one because that one's not on the board. Okay, don't write it on my desk. Try to memorize it. So we're going to do 4 times 3.14 times the radius 3 times. Well, if you put 14, you're going to miss it because 14 is my what?
Diameter.
So it should be 7 times 7 times 7. Lucky number 7. And then we got to divide by 3. Everybody with me? Now I'm not going to go do the math on it because you got to calculate. Make sure you multiply all of this and then press equals and then divide by 3. All right, next. This one is a parallelogram. So it's base times height. So put area equals base times height. Now watch carefully. You see this box? Color the box and put a dot. Wherever the dot touches, those are the ones you use. Are you up with? You're falling asleep on me now. Come on. Where today's Friday, you can sleep tomorrow. This right here touches 3.7. So one of them is 3.7 and the other one is 7.6. So multiply and you got your answer. 3 times 7 is 21. So it's got to be, I guess it's this one.
Yeah.
All right, the next one. The next one is called a triangle. So put area equals 1/2 base times height. I think that one's on the board. Again, color your box and put your dots. Do it right now so you remember over the weekend. It touches 5.4, so put 5.4, and then it touches the 2. And then you got to take half of that. So take 5.4 times 2, press equals, and then divide by 2. I get 5.4. So everybody clear on how to do the area of a triangle? Don't miss something easy like that, okay? All right, next. Am I almost done? All right, this one right here, put a star by it. You have 2 boxes. If you watch, you won't miss this one. Color the box and put dots. All right, thank you. Color the box and then put dots. Tell me what 2 numbers these dots touch. Well, it touches, to me, it looks like 24. And what else does it touch?
36.
Now put equals. Now go to your other box color your box. All right, and what does this box touch? 27 and H. Now, if you know how to solve an equation, you're finished. How will I solve this equation for H? I'm going to divide by what? I'm going to divide by what? 27. So let's multiply these two first. So put 24 times 36, press equals, and then divide by 27. And that should be your height. Your height is 32. Work this one a few times because I might double it up and give you two of them. So you don't want to say, oh, well, I'll miss that one. No, it ain't going to work that way because I might double it up on you. Any questions on what I did so far? All you do is go to your box and set it equal to that box and then work it out. It's not hard. It's actually pretty easy. But like I said, kids last year worked these same problems. Now look up here. Area of a trapezoid equals 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases. Well, let's do the bases first. The bases are the ones that are parallel, so that's going to be 8 plus 12. The height is going to go from base to base. Look at your box. Your box will tell you which one's the height. It's got to be 7. Now, let's finish it up. Well, this right here is 20, so clear your calculator. Press 20 times what? Times 7, press equals, and divide by 2. Make sure you press equals. That's the one I'm going to go with. Any questions on how to do the trapezoid? All right, let's set up the next one. I won't work it. I'll set it up. So it's 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases. The height goes from parallel to parallel. Here's your parallel. So this is your height. Make sure you know that. The other two are called legs. This one right here, I'm not sure what I want because it didn't say. So we'll do circumference and we'll do area like the bell work wanted you to do. So circumference is pi times diameter. So 3.14 times the diameter, which is 36. Remember, the diameter is all the way across. It's the bigger one. Area is pi radius squared. So it's 3.14 times 18 times 18. And then that should give you your answer. You got to multiply these by pi to check it. I think that's it. All right, this is on video. You can watch it this weekend. Please do, because it will help you. And good luck on your test Monday.